The trash bag is man crying out. It's made out of pumpkin. Fire hydrant is chocolate. We also have sugar water flowing out of here. For our tasting elements, we have white chocolate larva filled with a tropical fruit caviar and a yogurt panna cotta.
The panna cotta and the caviar of mango and passion fruit, that was so bright. It's a really interesting flavor that evolves. I don't think there's one focal point for me here, Brenda. I'm constantly looking for your gorgeous sculptures and your faces, and I think it's a little bit wasted on these mosquito characters.
I like them individually, but I don't know that it's working all as one piece. The fact that your main bug here goes past and above your backdrop, my eye is going up more towards the ceiling and I'm not really paying attention as much to the piece like I should be. But that fire hydrant is amazing. I mean, it looks like a real fire hydrant.
There are so many beautiful details on it, down to the goo coming out of the creature's nose. I also think that a focal point would have been helpful.
Burned of the cake, thank you very much. Buttercream beast, let's talk about your display.
This mad scientist tried the wrong formula. He has now mutated his rabbits into a real swarm. This mutant rabbit is made out of rice cereal, fondant, and cake. He's got some beautiful sugar talons. We've got sugar hypno wheel. The doctor's head is made out of pumpkin. The rabbits are made out of yams.
The treat we have for you tonight. Inside, you're going to find the flavors of chocolate, peanut butter, and thin wisps of caramelized sugar.
I really love the crunchiness of the caramel. You folded it just enough so that it's not overly smooth. You still left the texture there, so that was
what
really
are you
great.
Doing, retarded
so
teammate?
I have the privilege of playing werewolves, vampires, and zombies. I've never played a monster bunny. I would love to play this monster bunny. To have cute little bunnies be your killing aspect here, I think that's very original.
The way that it looks like the giant rabbit actually has fur, it's crazy.
Beth, this is one of the largest figures we've seen on Halloween Wars. And I like that you brushed the buttercream in the direction of where the fur would grow. Matt, you also created a lot here. We have the pumpkin head and these gorgeous squash bunnies, and they all have different personalities. We have so much cake, we have so much pumpkin, and with the sugar we have the teeth, the nails, and the hypno wheel that isn't turning. I would like to see a lot more from you.
Frosted Freak Show, you're up.
When the people agreed to dispose of the toxic waste from a neighboring city, their beloved bees had mutated into a swarm of radioactive monsters. The large bees are made of rice cereal treats and modeling chocolates with sugar wings. All the small bees are sweet potato. The hives are pumpkin and radioactive sugar slime.
For the tasting element, we have a traditional honeycomb dipped in chocolate and sitting on a bee base.
Reva, not only did you put honey into it, you also created this honeycomb texture. Just delicious.
So you guys definitely took the theme to the extreme here. This is the epitome of a swarm.
Jeez, you've done so much here. Besides hundreds of bees, we also created these honeycombs.
That face on the other side over there is really haunting, so if that had been up front, it would have been a really cool element. The one thing I will say is more color breakup would have been helpful.
My gosh, this is a whole lot of yellow, guys.
It is a lot of yellow, but that is totally my thing, so I completely dig it. It's so visually pleasing. Fantastic.
Frosted Freak Show, thank you very much. Teams, after all these swarms, the judges need some space.
Once again, our color contrast is completely off. This is the difference between us winning money or going home.
This was not our best work. There's no focal point. We are in trouble.
Yes, you are.
Judges, four teams remain. Four different
sports. All right, buddy. You need to go run for your seat.
That crazy rabbit. It would be so time-consuming and difficult to cover that whole thing and find it. And so she created movement in the buttercream to suggest fur, and I think that's really, really smart.
It's amazing how much they're able to pull off in this time. The glowing eyes, and there's so many cool elements about this.
It's pretty terrifying. I think it could absolutely belong on a movie poster.
I'm a little concerned with Rebecca.
If they hadn't spent so much time on the hypno wheel, they probably would have had more time to do shadowing and bring it up a little bit more. But that hypno wheel really took a lot of time.
One of my favorite pantry items is peanut butter. And Rebecca did a really great job of folding that into caramel and chocolate. So she did just enough so that we still tasted that crunch of the caramel.
It was good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Let's move on to Frosted Freak Show.
Frosted Freak Show, they tend to make their pieces really busy. That there had been one big main bug that was your queen bee, and then the rest of it could have just kind of fallen in place.
They gave us yellow on yellow, and the backdrop didn't have any kind of dimension. All the wasps that James did, oh my gosh, they actually had a furry character to the bodies.
They were cool.
Yeah, I think it was like the dry brushing.
I love this piece. The closer you look on the piece, the more details you can see, which is really exciting.
Riva's tasting succeeded on all three levels. Taste, texture, and appearance. There was nothing overly sweet about it. The taste was actually rather silky,